Do you want to learn how to build your own SMTP mail server? Send emails with no limits using a free and open source mail server called Postal. In this video, I will show you how to create your own SMTP mail server to send unlimited emails for free. Yes, for free. In only 10 minutes and in the easiest way you'll ever see. Stay tuned and follow up with me. Okay, friends, before we start, please don't forget, subscribe to my channel to get every new update almost every day. So let's not waste time and start together by building our free SMTP server. So what's required for this video? Simply, you need two things, a domain name and a VPS server to install and set up your SMTP server on. So in my case, I'm using here GoDaddy, and I have this sample domain name for this tutorial. If you don't have a domain name, please go and get one. The second thing you need is a VPS server. I will be using DigitalOcean because it's super simple. And you can find in the description below a free coupon so you can use DigitalOcean totally for free for 1 month and test everything for free. So let's dive in and start creating our VPS server and configuring our SMTP server. So here we are in DigitalOcean. Please sign up using the link in the description so you can get a free coupon and test everything for free. Simply in DigitalOcean, click on create to create a new VPS or what's called a droplet inside DigitalOcean. Click droplet and now just select Ubuntu and go with Ubuntu 16 and then go down and let's select a $10 machine. As I told you, it's free for you. And then go down, select a region you want. I will keep the default now. And then here you need to choose a host name. What is the host name? Simply, it's a subdomain of your domain. So in my case, it's xmailing.me. I will say here like server.xmailing.me. So simple. Now let's go down and click create droplet. So simple. Let's wait a little bit and DigitalOcean will create everything for you and send you the credentials to your email address. That's it. So simple. I will open my Gmail account, which is my email that I registered in DigitalOcean with. And now in a little bit, DigitalOcean will send you an email. I will wait for maybe 1 minute. By the way, friends, if you are totally new to this field and you don't know anything about VPS servers, about droplets, about domains, about DNS and so on, I really advise you to enroll in my Udemy course to understand everything from scratch. You can get only for $10, I think now it's on sale. So go and grab it now and learn from scratch to understand all the ideas, all the concepts before you go and build anything. Anyway, now let's continue our work and build our SMTP server. So you can see I got my email from DigitalOcean and here we are. This is the IP address and this is the root password of my server. So simple, copy this IP and go and open an application called PuTTY. PuTTY is a free SSH client that allows you to configure your server. You'll find a download link in the description. You can get it. It's totally free and it's a simple tool. Just paste the IP here and click on open. You will see how things is really simple. Click yes. And then we will log in as root. It will ask you for the password. Just copy this. Copy. Go here. Now to paste the password, just right click on your mouse and click enter. And here we are. It will tell you to change the password, enter the current password again, right click to paste, enter. Now enter a new password, retype it again, and here we are. We are ready to set up our SMTP server. Now we need to run one simple command and everything will be automated. Let's see together. Just paste this command here and everything will start automatically. You will find the command in the description below. Just copy, right click, paste it, and you will see the setup will start automatically and everything is automated. The setup will run and the SMTP server will be installed. Let's wait a little bit and I'll be with you again. And awesome, you can see installation complete. You don't need to do anything, just run one simple command. Now we need to create a user to access our system. So say postal make user. So simple, enter. And now it will ask you for some details like your email address. I will enter my email address. I will enter my name, my last name. Enter the password you want for the system. And here we are. Now, how to access our mail server and configure it? Simply, you can use your IP address. I will copy this. Go to my browser, enter the IP here, click enter. It will show you this unsecure message. It's okay for SSL. Click on advanced and proceed. It's only for the first time. Click proceed. And here we are. Welcome to Postal. Enter the email and the password you set. And awesome, here we are inside our Postal SMTP mail server. The first thing you need to do is to create an organization. So click create the first organization. I will name it Educate. Just enter whatever name you want and click create organization. Then we need to build our first mail server. Build our mail server. I will name it Educate mail server. Set it to live mode and click build server. Let's wait a little bit. You see, things are really very simple. With only two commands and few clicks, our server is ready. Now we need to add our domain. So simply go to domains here and then click add your first domain. What is my domain name? I will be using this domain, xmailing.me, and click create domain. Very simple. Now it will give you SPF, DKIM, and UTM path, a max record, and everything you need to do to set up your DNS records. If you don't know what is SPF, DKIM, DMARC, or DNS, please refer to my videos here on my channel. I explained everything in detail. So now I will go to my DNS management zone and I want to point my domain name to my VPS server, to my SMTP server, so I can access the server using a name instead of an IP address. Simply just edit this at a record, the main record in the DNS zone, click edit, remove this IP, and I will get the IP of my new server and paste it here. So simple, and save. And the second thing I want to do is to create a subdomain. If you remember, I named the server as server.xmailing. So just create a new A record here for my subdomain server and point the same IP and click save. Very simple. So now we can access our SMTP server using the IP address. To ensure that the domain and the IP now are mapped, just go to this tool here. ping.eu/ping and simply I will say xmailing.me to ping this host name and say ej, enter the code and click go. And you can see my domain is pointing to this new IP address. So everything is successful. Now I can access my server using the domain name. Let's see together. I will say now xmailing.me. You can see now, proceed the first time using this domain. And here we are, we can access our Postal SMTP mail server using our domain instead of the IP address. Awesome. So now let's continue and set up SPF and DKIM. Simply copy this. Just pay attention that this is only an example, spf.postalexample.com. Just copy it and go to domain manager, click on add, simply say text record, enter add as host name, and then the value, I will remove everything and keep only A and MX and click on save. So simple. And for the DKIM, just copy this and go again, add a text record, and the value, paste it here, and just copy this domain key and paste it here and click on save. And here we are, we set up SPF and DKIM. Now to verify your settings using a third-party tool, I recommend you to use MX Toolbox. Just go to MX Toolbox and click on More, you'll find a lot of tools. Just open the SPF and the DKIM to validate our results. And now I will enter my domain here, click SPF record lookup. And awesome, we have an SPF record, and let's go to DKIM. Here is the domain. Here is the identifier, the selector, and here is my domain. Click DKIM lookup. And awesome, you can see DKIM also is verified. So we set up DKIM and SPF, and our server now is ready to send emails. Let's test our server. Simply go to smtper.net and we need to test our SMTP. I will copy this domain here. You can use also the IP if you want, whatever you want, use authentication. Now you need to create a credential for this SMTP. So simply go to credentials here and click add your first credential. I will say SMTP. By the way, it has an API also. Say SMTP, I will name it as user one and generate automatically, create credential. Here we are, open this user, copy this, paste it here. Copy this key, the password, and paste it here. And I will say, as an example, mail@xmailing.me, the from email and the email to address. Enter this captcha and click send the test. And awesome, mail successfully sent. So our SMTP server is working and everything is awesome. So you can see how easy it is to configure and set up a free SMTP server using Postal mail server. Look, I want to tell you something. If your messages was sent to spam, it's normal. It's still a new server with a brand new IP address. You need to warm up your server and then get good reputation so you can reach the inbox. I talked about this a lot here on my channel, how to inbox, how to reach the inbox. Please check my email marketing playlist. You will find a lot of interesting videos. Also, I want to point to something very important. Postal, this open free SMTP, has an IP pool option. It's similar to IP rotation concept in PowerMTA, and it's free. If you are interested in learning more about Postal, how things work inside, how to configure advanced settings, please comment below on this video so I can know you are interested and create more videos about this topic. Now you may be asking how I can send bulk messages or start an email marketing campaign using this server. Simply, you need to connect it with a mailing application. Please refer to my description. I have a full article for beginners, email marketing startup guide. It's very important to read and understand the basic concepts before you go and start your first email marketing campaign. Simply, you can get an application like Mailwizz, Mailster, SendBlaster. All are explained here on my YouTube channel. Please refer to my playlist and you'll find a lot of videos help you start your first email marketing campaign.